editing this image of my daughter. We was doing a ballerina-inspired photo shoot at home. As you can see, I've just used a plain grey sheet as the backdrop. I'm just sitting on a grey blanket. So I'm just going to be cleaning the background up a little bit, making some changes to her little skirt here and some skin edits. So let's start. So first I am going to make her a little bit brighter. So I'm going to make an adjustment layer. Command J. Then I'm going to select my subject. Okay, I'm going to get the selection a bit better than it is at the moment. Okay, now that's done, I'm going to make a levels adjustment layer. So just going to bring my white point down to the bottom of the mountain, just thereabouts. I'm going to bring my midpoint down, just brighten her up a little bit more, just about there. Okay, now I'm going to go in and I'm going to make sure it's where I need it. I might And with my brush, I'm just going to go over and make sure all of these areas are added. Okay, now I'm going to darken the background very slightly. Make a curves adjustment layer. Option, drag, replace layer mask. Yeah, but I'm going to invert that. And then I'm going to click back on the curves properties and just darken it ever so slightly. I'm going to merge and I'm going to clean up the background more so. So to start with, I am going to Command J, duplicate layer, select subject, and just add in any areas. I'm only worrying about the bottom over here, really, because I just want to clean up just this part of the background here. I don't want it to affect her. So now that I've got that done, I am going to go into Select and Inverse. And then I'm going to select my clone stamp by pressing S. Bigger stamp. Option. Because I've got this selected, it's not going to affect the subject at all. Okay, Command D to deselect. Now I'm going to work on her skin. So I'm going to make a new, I'm going to merge this down. I'm going to make a new adjustment, duplicate layer, Command J. Make her bigger. I'm just going to clean up the skin. Command J. Okay. And then J for my spot healing brush. And just take out any pimples or any skin distractions. Okay, I'm going to be using an action that I have downloaded. I will leave a link in the description. It's a skin action. So I'm just going to put it here. It's from Sweet Soul Studios. play. Like that one. It says mask on, skin with a soft white, low opacity brush. So I'm just going to B for brush. And it automatically is inverse the mask, so you just go and paint it on. So I'm just going to go ahead and paint. It just helps soften and smooth out. I prefer using these kind of brush actions over frequency separation. Moving really quick. I'm going to do all the hard work and just give it a nice soft finish. See, it just smooths everything down, just gives you a nice even base to work with. Okay. So I'm happy with that. So I'm going to merge visible. Then I'm going to do some build and burn. I have actions for this, just because it's just easier and quicker just to play the actions. Okay, start with dodge as always. I'm going to start on her face. So my opacity I will take right down to about 10. Soft round brush. I'm just going to come into the areas. Ooh, that's not a soft brush. Soft brush would help. Okay, try that again. I'm just going to come into upper forehead. Bring some light back here. Down the bridge of the nose. Swipe there. Upper brow. Upper eyelid, sorry, and under the brow bone. And right in the hole. So centre of the lips here. And I'm just going to put the natural highlights on her arms. Just one or two swipes. Collarbone here. Around her fingers. Okay. A little bit over her ear. Now for the burn, I'm going to bring the opacity down even more so I just as tight. And for the face, I'm going to do one swipe across the forehead. And come down to from her temple down to her cheekbone. Side of the nose. Around the nostrils, under the nose here, do it in front of her nose, line the lips, give them a little bit more depth, on the outer side of the cupid's bow, and a little chin a bit there. I'm going to go over the eyebrows very slightly. Over her lash line. Under her jaw shadow here. I'm going to group those. So shift on both, command G. That's my first group. I'm going to do that again. Make another layer. I'm about to build up with my dodge and burn. I'm going to fix up this little part of her dress down here. So first I'm going to merge this. Duplicate AI commands and J. Then I am going to use the patch tool. And I'm simply just going to sample and patch over. I'm going to get this bit here. I'm just going to move it. Let's grab an area. Okay, I think I'm going to extend the crop on this. So, I'm just going to drag this out and center it. About that, content aware film. Let's see what it does. Not too bad at all. So now I'm going to add in some background. File, place embedded. I'm going to start with this one here, place. I'm going to bring it up just to about here and accept and turn it off. Back to my background, select subject, add a layer mask, and then just invert that mask. Take the opacity down a fair bit, about here. Add my next texture, file, place embedded. I'm just going to bring this up. Stretch it upwards. Okay. option, and drag, replace layer mask. Okay, bring the opacity down. Play with the opacities of both until the background is as I want it. I think I like it about there. Okay, what I'm going to do, I am going to merge this. I'm going to darken the background just a slight bit. So curves, watching for the backgrounds only. Subject. Back onto here. X for black brush, V for brush. Make it larger. Opacity way up. Just take it off. Come on, do deselect B and just again. Oops. Come on, do deselect and just I'm going to take it off the rest of this. The dress here. Okay. Merge for them. I want to darken the whole image a slight bit. But I will take it off of her face just ever so slightly. So down to about 20 or so. And just take it off of her face. A little gradient map. That little bit of glow. See, it's down at 7%, so it's the slightest effect on it, but it does make a big difference. Love it like that. That's an image. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.